This is how my computer was running Far Cry 3 in 800 by 600 before. And this is how it's running now on a higher resolution, same scene. How? Well, keep watching and I will explain how to get the most out of this critically acclaimed game on your low-end computer. This is the Low Spec Gamer, where low detail shadows make us happy and the lower the resolution, the bigger the fun. So forget about depth of field and HDR because we are making this game run. This is the lowest preset for Far Cry 3. As you can see, the lowest preset throws everything to its lowest, and the video screen grays out most of the other graphical options when playing on DirectX 9. Testing while on 720p gives me between 10 FPS while standing around and 15 while trying to drive. And on 800x600, which is the lowest allowed resolution, it gives us about 15 while standing and 25 while driving, with some slowdowns. And so, the tweaking begins. First, make sure your Far Cry 3 settings are set to custom inside the game. Then, we're going to do some changes to the Far Cry 3 configuration file located in your document folder, My Games, Far Cry 3, GameProfile.xml, and you can open this with Notepad or Notepad++. First, we're going to go through the custom settings and make sure all elements are set too low, since a couple of elements are a bit higher than they should. Also, reduce the quality settings on the FireConfig, RealTree profile, and the Engine profile. You can disable depth of field by setting the post effects quality value to false, and you can disable HDR by setting the HDR value to 0. You may have noticed that Ambient Occlusion is grayed out while on DirectX 9 and on DirectX 11 you cannot disable it. To do that, simply change SSAO level to 0. Here's a tweak for those of you not playing on the absolute lowest. You can disable motion blur by adding this tag after the custom tag. This will work even on the higher settings, and this tag will be in the description if you need to copy it. And with only those changes, you will already see an important difference even while playing on 720p. If you want to change to a custom resolution, it is as simple as changing the parameters on resolution X and resolution Y to the resolution you want. I will be using 960 by 540 to preserve the widescreen resolution for now. Oh, and most custom resolutions work pretty well on full screen. Be sure to set the file as read-only so the game does not change your tweaks. Well, that's promising. That's even better performance than what I was getting on 800x600. Oh, that's a boar right there. Okay, let's see. No, 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 get back here. This is not how hunting is supposed to. Come on, man. If you're still unhappy with this level of performance, there are still a couple of things you can do. This is the ultra-low configuration mod for Far Cry 3 that introduces changes to draw distance, level of details, as well as reductions to shadow, reflections, and other effects. Installing it is as easy as downloading the two files in the mod and then going to your Far Cry 3 installation folder. For Steam, this is located at your program files, Steam, Steam apps, Common, Far Cry 3, and you need to go into the Data Win32 folder. Create a backup folder and backup your patch.dat and patch.fat so you can go back to the non-modded game if you ever need to, and then you can copy the modified patch.dat and patch.fat from the mod into the folder. This should provide a significant amount of performance compared to what we were doing before. Let's try something a bit more intense. Now, stealth has always been one of my weakest abilities while gaming. Oh, this is an excellent example of what the shadows, what the mod does to the shadows. Fantastic. Okay. There goes stealth. As I said. Not my best suit. Oh, freaking hell. Well, time to test on performance, I guess. How do I... Okay. That's better. All right, not bad.
Reloading, cover me.
Right. And. Ha! Perfect. They are all dead. Well done. Hey, look at that amazing level of detail at the distance. If you still want to go further in order to get some extra performance out of those intense gunfights, you can customize the resolution under the minimum 800x600 allowed and they will work on full screen. Let's try 640x400. Now this is low resolution. Now this is the game that I wanted to play. Fantastic. Oh boy, now this looks interesting. Let's give it a try. Oh, can I fire from here? Okay, so I haven't seen much action in this resolution, and I'm eager to test. I'm already seeing just how many things are not showing at this distance, but I want to see just how well the game does an action scenes using this resolution. So, oh, that was a little bit less pleasant than I expected. Oh, okay, much better. Oh, this is not how you drive a car. What am I doing? How do you even... Ah, crap. Crap, ah, shit. Incoming! Okay. Whoa, okay. Right. Time to test performance while shooting! Can't hide! You're using red shirts in the middle of grass. Come on, man. Ha! Flawless.
That is all for this video. Thank you to all Patreon contributors for making this possible. And to finish, LowSpecGamer giveaway. Last time, I asked about which game would be better if it was procedurally generated. The winners are the following. Congratulations to you all. This time I want you to answer the following. What would be the worst setting for a Far Cry game? You could win one of these games by answering the question on comments, Twitter, Facebook or the Steam group. The grand prize being a copy of Chivalry, Medieval Warfare. Please, also share which country you are on, some of these prizes are region locked.
Units. Oh, I feel just... This is how I feel when I walk into a computer shop.